Where's the fucking shark movies at? Oh my god, shark movies! Shark movies! There's a shark movie! Oh, there's another shark movie! Oh, another one! Hey, another one! Hey, another one! Shark movie! 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 Shark movie!
Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark
movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie!
Shark movie! Shark movie!
Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie!
Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie!
Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark
movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie! Shark movie!
So let's take a look at all the shark movies that brought the genre back to its low-class roots. There's so many, I had to be very selective. So I narrowed it down to 40. So let's dive in. It's Cinemassacre's top 40 shitty shark movies. Number 40. Jaws 2. Just when you thought it was safe to go back in the water, Roy Scheider's gotta deal with that smiling son of a bitch all over again. What I love about the sequel is that even after the shark gets its face blown off, it comes back for more, like it's Freddy Krueger or something. Number 39. Jaws 3. Yeah, you see what I'm doing here. This time the shark goes crazy at SeaWorld. It's a deadly new attraction with Jaws 3. What really made the sequel stand out, it was in 3D. Yeah! The highlight is an explosion of shark guts. Number 38. Jaws 4, The Revenge. It's no mystery anymore. The shark is deliberately stalking the Brody family, and is literally seeking revenge for its exploding death by Chief Brody in the original Jaws. I know it's probably supposed to be from the same shark family, but I like to think it's the same shark that somehow resurrected itself. I mean, the shark here actually follows Brody's widow from Massachusetts to the Bahamas, and it roars. If you could accept all that, you could accept anything. Wait a minute. That's not how the movie ends. I remember seeing it on TV, and you actually see the shark getting stabbed by the tip of the boat. It's such an iconic ending, they even used it in an NES game from LJN. But the version that ended up in theaters had the ending changed, to have the shark spontaneously explode instead. And this is the version that's on all the DVDs. So why can you see the original uncut ending on TV, but not on the DVD? Who knows? Number 37. Shark Kill. From 1976, this may in fact be the first Jaws ripoff ever made. It's about two men hunting a killer shark. It was made for TV, and you want to talk about shit? Look how shitty this DVD is. It looks like they filmed it off the TV in 1976 with an 8mm film camera, then years later projected it on a wall and filmed it with a VHS camera, then eventually digitized the movie from the VHS tape, then compressed it to reduce the file size, then put it on the DVD, then I got the DVD, put it in this video, so now you're seeing it on the internet. Looks great, doesn't it? Number 36. Shark Hunter. It's technology versus nature when man seeks revenge against the shark that killed his family.
God, you son of a bitch!
You know, sharks are getting kind of tired of always being called sons of bitches. Or sons of bitches, yeah. That'd be multiple sons of multiple bitches. Number 35. Shark Zone. Treasure seekers go to the bottom of the ocean to find some hidden loot. But too bad for them, they venture into the shark zone. Then the shark comes to terrorize the beaches. Have you seen Jaws? Then you've seen Shark Zone. Number 34. Shark. Yeah, how about just plain shark? The real sharks in this movie are swindlers. People who try to cheat others out of hidden treasure. But we do get some shark action. If you want to call it action. I think we've been spoiled with all these newer shark movies. But this one has a very unique distinction. It predates Jaws. Number 33. Terror Storm. After a cyclone hits, a group of people are stranded in the ocean, and then our favorite eating machine comes and picks them all off. Number 32. Sharks in Venice. We have a son seeking his missing father, a long-lost fortune, mafia assassins, a kidnapped girlfriend, and killer sharks. Yep, all in beautiful Venice. Number 31. Spring Break Shark Attack. A bunch of people on vacation get attacked by sharks. Lots of them. This year, spring break really bites. Number 30. Monster Shark. Marine biologists and the local sheriff hunt down a creature in the marshlands that's one part shark and one part octopus. It's a hot time in the old town tonight. Number 29. Dark Tide. Halle Berry plays a shark expert who returns to the waters after a year of being haunted by a terrible shark encounter. But the nightmare from the deep is still lurking, more carnivorous and hungry than ever. Number 28. Blue Demon. Scientists are trying to train sharks to protect the American coast from terrorists. But when the sharks break loose, everybody's in real trouble. Your deepest fears lie beneath the surface with Blue Demon. Number 27. Bait. A freak tsunami traps shoppers inside a supermarket with a great white. We're gonna need a cleanup on aisle 7. Number 26. Raging Sharks. The reason these sharks are raging is because an alien ship crashed in the ocean and sends off a field of magnetic pulses which drives the sharks into a frenzy to attack the undersea labs as well as the good old-fashioned beaches. And that's the same stock footage of people running from Shark Zone. If you want a movie that's both The Abyss and Jaws, then look no further. Number 25. Dark Waters. This time, it's a deep-sea oil rig in the Gulf of Mexico which gets attacked. Experts go underwater to investigate, but have to fight against the sharks.
You son of a bitch!
Number 24. Shark Swarm. When a greedy real estate developer releases toxins into the ocean, the sharks somehow get a major appetite. And if you choose to watch this movie, you better have a large appetite as well. It's nearly 3 hours long. Number 23, Shark Night. It's from the director of Final Destination and Snakes on a Plane. But apparently you don't need something as crazy as snakes on a plane because sharks in the water don't seem to get old for anybody. Forget about jumping the shark. This time, the shark jumps you. Number 22, Redwater. Ocean sharks, lake sharks, this time it's a river shark. Sooner or later, it's gonna be a shark in a fucking bathtub. This shark terrorizes hapless swimmers and deep sea divers looking for treasure. But there's no treasure to be found in this shitty shark movie. Number 21, Hammerhead. This movie, you need a hammer to open the DVD. How did I get a DVD that's been welded shut? I'm not even making this up. The DVD won't open. Gotta get the fucking shark movie open. Open, you son of a bitch! Gotta get the shark movie! I gotta get the shark movie! Anyway, the setting is some kind of science lab where Jeffrey Combs from Reanimator tries to cure cancer using shark DNA, but it turns a newborn baby into a hammerhead. This movie is one part Island of Dr. Moreau, one part Frankenstein, and one part Friday the 13th. Yeah, the only movie where you can see a shark stalking someone in the woods. Or maybe there's others. Probably. Also, gotta love the explosions. Number 20. Swamp Shark. A genetically enhanced shark goes on a rampage through a campground in Louisiana. This shark is a master decapitator. Number 19, Malibu Shark Attack. When Malibu is flooded, all these prehistoric goblin sharks come with it, and a group of lifeguards have to stop them. When shark movies start using rare species such as goblin sharks, I think we might have had enough. Number 18, Shark Attack in the Mediterranean. Let's be specific now, because it's only about the 800th film with Shark Attack in the title. The plot centers around a helicopter pilot whose wife was killed by a shark, and there's all this drama and shit, but who cares? Here's the good part. Megalodon. A deep sea drilling operation in the North Atlantic waters accidentally releases 60 feet of prehistoric terror, the Megalodon shark. No! Number 16, Shark Attack. In an African fishing village, the sharks begin attacking the population. It turns out the sharks here are acting this way because scientists have been enlarging their brain cells to extract enzymes that could cure cancer. Does it sound like I'm giving the same synopsis more than once? Well, maybe it's because the same fucking movie's been made again and again. Just play the Shark Attack board game instead. A shark escapes from a Waterworld theme park. Now that we're ripping off Jaws 3, we're sinking real deep. But you can't go without all the original Jaws moments. The classic scene with the diver in the cage is a must, as well as the typical beach scenes. If you're a sharkaholic and need to see the same thing over and over again, this is for you. Number 14. Shark Attack 3, Megalodon. That's right, because the year 2002 needed more than one Megalodon movie. Remember this shot from Jaws? You could potentially take all these shots from each of these movies and cut together a complete recreation of Jaws. But the most famous clip of all, this asshole takes a girl's life jacket, but he gets what he deserves. Yeah. And there's this schmuck on a jet ski. Number 13. Psycho Shark. Supposedly it has an alternate title, Jaws in Japan. That's what you gotta love about all these rip-offs. They're so self-aware. This movie is 100% shit, except for one crazy huge shark. Number 12. Deep Blue Sea. This one makes the list for one reason. Samuel L. Goddamn Jackson.
So we're not going to fight anymore! We're going to pull together, and we're going to find a way to get out of here! First, we're going to see you off the floor. Deep Blue Sea! They ate me! I'll fuck you, sir! Ate me! Great kids!
Number 11. Dino Shark. From producer Roger Corman comes a dinosaur-shark hybrid that breaks away from an Arctic glacier thanks to global warming. Shark Attack. That's right. One body, two heads, 6,000 teeth. Nuff said. Number 9. Sand sharks. Yeah, this time the sharks don't need water at all. They swim in the fucking sand. Amazing. One part Tremors, one part... What's that other movie again? Oh yeah, Jaws. How do all these movies get made? Number 8. Mega Shark vs. Crocosaurus. The only movie with Jaleel White as a soldier battling against the Megalodon, battling against the Crocosaurus.
Did I do that?
I shipped you, son of a bitch! Number 7. Mega Shark vs. Giant Octopus. Forget being afraid of the sea or the sand. Here, even the air isn't safe. Holy shit! Number 6. Sharktopus, again from Roger Corman. Holy crap! A shark and an octopus together as one. Already done in Monster Shark, but not as epically as this. What is the world coming to when we're making the same shark hybrid movies more than once? Man, that was a bad time to be ziplining. This flick is outrageous and begs the question, what will they come up with next? You wanna know? Number 5. Sharknado! Sharks in tornadoes!
we took my grandfather.
This is the latest in the current wave of shark exploitation films. It just premiered on the Sci-Fi Channel weeks ago. It comes out on DVD in September. I didn't even know about it. I was already buried deep working on this list, getting it ready in time for Shark Week. And here comes this fucking movie, makes a big splash. I have to fit it into the list. And now I hear Sharknado 2 is in the works, and there's Ghost Shark coming out this month. I can't even get this video done faster than these movies are coming out. Number 4. Attack of the Jurassic Shark. I spent hours just trying to find a Jurassic Shark and Attack of the Jurassic Shark is the same movie. I don't fucking know, but this time, Spielberg's gotta be real proud. Not only are they playing with Jaws, but Jurassic Park. This movie is truly shitty, without a doubt. Makes the acting in some of these other movies seem Oscar-worthy.
For what? You kill us? Really, between you and it? You're no threat.
Snow Shark. Yeah, forget the abominable snowman. The real terror is the shark. Not even Santa is safe. Number 2. Jersey Shore Shark Attack. What makes this different from all the other shark movies, or at least all the other shark movies from 2012, is that it's set in Seaside Heights. All the characters are in some way knockoffs of people from the Jersey Shore TV show. Every character is exaggerated to be as annoying as possible.
Oh, that's the sound of my heart fluttering as I look upon your kick-ass body.
So, if you want to see a bunch of douchebags getting eaten by sharks, don't miss it. Boy, all these shark movies were a mouthful, but now we're down to the last plate. Number 1. Super Shark. Chomp down this ship. A drilling accident triggers the awakening of another prehistoric shark. This has everything. It has awful acting, it's terrible all around, and has a shark that is not down by the water. This shark is completely out of control. The army can't even stop it. And it gets better. They bring in the mecha weapons. What can I say about this movie? Just look at it. If you want a shark movie that's shitty but amazing at the same time, check it out. Super Shark is super shit.